Over now to former U.S. President Donald Trump's legal woes. Fulton County District Attorney Fannie Willis seeking to start Trump's trial in March next year. This means Trump would have to appear in court in the middle of his campaign for the 2024 Republican presidential nomination. Now, the proposed March 4 trial date is one day before the so-called Super Tuesday, where voters in more than a dozen states are set to cast their ballots. A Georgia grand jury indicted Trump and 18 others for seeking to undo his 2020 election loss. Aside from Georgia, Trump will also be on trial in New York on March 25th in his hush money case. A U.S. appeals court upholds limits to access to abortion pill mifepristone, but it stopped short of pulling the drug off the market, and the drug will be banned on telemedicine prescriptions and shipments by mail. But the latest decision will not take effect until the Supreme Court reviews it. The ruling stems from a lawsuit brought by four anti-abortion groups in November. Over now to the U.S. as we get the latest on the Maui wildfires from our North America Bureau correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are the news-making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with Filipinos frantically searching for missing loved ones after wildfires ravished the island of Maui. Members of the U.S. Army and National Guard are assisting Hawaiian first responders as they continue search and rescue efforts following deadly wildfires that flattened Maui's historic town of Lahaina last week. At least 106 have been killed and 2,200 buildings have been destroyed. About 1,300 people remain unaccounted for. One of them is Ilocano grandfather Rudy Rokutan.
He was supposed to be with his sister, my grandmother, who he's living with. And they got separated because my grandmother tried to get her bag from the garage, but it was already burning down.
Meanwhile, one Filipino family is missing nine members, Adela and Joel Villegas, their daughter Angelica Bakling, and son Jun Marquijano, Lydia and Salvador Coloma, their niece Glenda Yabes, and brother and sister Luz Bernabe and Felimon Quijano. If you have any information on any of these loved ones, please contact the American Red Cross hotline at this number. Meanwhile, Hawaii Governor Josh Green has signed an order providing some access to Lahaina. A highway into Lahaina reopened on Wednesday, giving access to residents and first responders for the first time since wildfire swept over the resort town last week. Police could be seen directing traffic on the Lahaina bypass, which authorities said would be open to the public from 6 a.m. through 10 p.m. local time daily. The public is not allowed to go into the impact zone where the tragedy occurred. Officials are urging people to access West Maui only if necessary to live, work, or volunteer. Governor Green says opening the roads will begin the healing process of people in Maui.
We want information. We want to know where our loved ones are. We want to know where our friends are. And we want to know if they're safe. If they're injured. So I feel information will help us move forward on what to do.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. Back to you guys at the rundown.
Now we're in India at 71 killed following landslides and flooding in the Himalayan region. The search for bodies is ongoing, with only a dozen recovered so far. The destruction from the landslides was severe in India's Himachal Pradesh, where around 2,500 people were displaced. Now, homes and buildings there were also destroyed. Power was cut off in the state.